Hi class, welcome to another lecture on CS 575. So this time we just need a summary that we have learned in the previous two lectures. So the process of identifying an ARIMA model requires experience and good judgment, right? So as we saw, we could have multiple models if you just see the ACF and PCF. So that just gives a rough estimate and not a perfect estimate. So the following guidelines can be helpful. So make the series stationary in mean and variance. So obviously we can only apply AR, MA, ARIMA, ARMA on stationary time series. So first step is this. Differencing will take care of non-stationary. You may also have to do other kind of transformations like logarithmic or power transformation, right? So we are not covering this, but you can just go on net and read about it. So you can also, you may also have to do seasonal differencing if the data is seasonal in nature. Second thing, consider a non-seasonal aspect, right? So we are considering if the data is non-seasonal, you compute the ACF and PCF of the stationary data, and from the previous steps can reveal whether MA or AR is feasible, right? From the PCF, we get the AR thing, and from the ACF, we get the MA thing. So exponential decay or damped sine wave, right? So if we have the exponential decay and the damped sine wave, for PACF at spikes at lag 1 to P, so we have significant spikes from 1 to P, then cut off to 0, it indicates a ARP model may suffice. Similarly, spikes at lag 1 to Q and then cut off to 0 for ACF, right? So ACF basically indicates the MA and the parameter Q. Right, so if you have a ACF and then you have significant lags at till the lag Q and then it cuts to zero, then you may say that it's a MAQ model. And similarly, if you have a PACF which spikes from lag 1 to P and then cut off to zero, it indicates a ARP model. And then considering the seasonal aspect. So seasonal aspect is similar in nature except for the fact that you need to either difference from the seasonal series, right? You take a seasonal difference. For example, if you have a quarterly data, you may have R4, R8, R12. These are nothing but the spikes on that particular point. This is the fourth month, eighth month, right? So you may have a ACF like this for seasonal data and other points may be lying in between. Okay. So this was just a brief summary. So what you see from a ACF, PCF, and a simple time series plot. So this covers the first step of Box-Jenkins methodology, that is model identification, right? So in the next lecture, we see the step two, which is basically estimation. And there we basically come across AIC and BIC, which is to evaluate how complex your model is and what is the significance of AIC and BIC. So thank you class for watching.